Hey everyone, my name is Kevin and welcome back to Zach Lane Records. Today, I'm going to do a quick unboxing and review of the RK84, a budget 75% mechanical keyboard by Royal Kludge. This keyboard is owned by my friend Christopher the Kigz. He allowed me to get my hands on the board, check it out, and mod it for him. Please note that there is another version of the RK84 that can connect up to 5 devices. I am unsure if the one my friend bought is the older model or the newer model, as it doesn't come up from my research. Let's dive in deeper. The keyboard box is a typical RK branded box we normally see from Royal Kludge. It has branding everywhere, and on the backside, you can see the layout of the keyboard itself. I'm not a fan of the packaging, but it gets the job done. When you open the box, you are greeted with the RK84 wrapped in packing material. It has an included QR code that links you to the instructions manual. It also has 2 plastic feet with magnets that adjust the height of the keyboard, a Type-C cable, a wired keycap puller, a metallic switch remover, and 4 RK red switches. The RK84 looks super clean and compact. This specific model is priced at 2,867 pesos only, and for its 75% form factor, is a great budget board to consider having as your first keyboard. What's great about this keyboard is despite its budget-oriented pricing, it still packs a punch. The RK84 features a 5-pin hot-swappable PCB that is compatible with all Cherry MX-style switches. This specific model comes with white LED backlighting. You also have multiple options to connect the keyboard to a device through either Bluetooth 5.0 mode, wired mode, or through 2.4 GHz connectivity using the included dongle. It also has 2 USB-A pass-throughs, which would come in useful if you want to connect some devices easily. The keyboard already has an 8-degree angle but can be increased to 12 degrees using the plastic feet I showed earlier. It also features a 3,700 mAh battery size, which can provide longer lasting usage than other wireless keyboards in the market today. Another amazing feature of the RK84 is the option to remove the frame of it to give it a different look. If you are into painting, this can allow for easier modification of the frame. Other than reviewing this board, I will also do modifications. First, the keycaps. My friend sent over these. These are PBT Mint keycaps he got from Shopee, from Kyushu to be exact. He also sent his extremely overlubed Duroc Koalas with almost crusty springs, which I had to clean and redo myself. I will also be adding foam to the case and as well as modding the stock stabilizers. Before I do any modifications, here's a sound test on how the board is before anything is done to it. Now, to the mods. Thank you. Now we're done. Let's listen to a sound test. Would I recommend this keyboard? Yes I would. For the price of 2,867 pesos only, the Royal Kludge RK84 Mechanical Keyboard is definitely a great board for anyone who is going into the world of mechanical keyboards. Especially if you want the function rows but want it in a compact size, then this keyboard is perfect for you. This board also paves the way to more customizability, not only with how it feels, how it sounds, but with how it looks as well. For gaming, the included 2.4 GHz dongle is not that good, and I would honestly just use this in wire mode to avoid any possible latency issues. The stock stabs were not the best, but did come pre-lube. The RK Brown switches were not horrible, but would definitely need some TLC to make them feel and sound better. What do you think about this board? Would you consider buying this? Leave a comment down below, let's discuss. Thank you again to Kigz for letting me review this keyboard. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this kind of content, make sure to subscribe to Zach Lane Records and hit the notification bell to receive updates on when my videos come out. Please like this video if you liked it, and if you didn't, let me know why. See you guys soon. Bye!